about two coordinate geometry. And when dealing with two coordinate geometry, we all know about straight line. This is all we'll be doing today. We're dealing with straight line, distance of the straight line, the polar coordinate, and the rest of them. Now, when dealing with straight line, what's a straight line? A straight line is a line that is straight. Jokingly, or a straight line is a distance from a point to another point without a curve. Now, from our xy graph, says, let's say we have our x and our y graph here, and then we have a point y2 and a point y1 here, and a point x1 and a point x2 here. So, having this, we have this to come out this way and x2 to intersect this way, and then a distance from this point to another point. We name this point Q to be x2, y2, and here P to be x1, y1, because this is on the xy line and the y1 line, this is on the x2 line and the y2 line. Now, about the straight line. One thing we can dispute about straight line, like we talked about in our video for vectors, is the gradient or slope. We found the slope there, and the slope is the vertical distance this line rises, which is the vertical distance this line rises all over the horizontal distance this line rises. In essence, this is our slope in two coordinates geometry is written as m is equals to the vertical distance this line rises from this point to this point, which is here to here, which is y2 minus y1, all over the horizontal distance here to here, which is x2 minus x1. So this is the slope of this line we have here. And this is the slope for solving the, this is the formula for solving the slope and the gradient of a straight line. Now, having distance on a straight line, there's something we won't dispute. If we name this D to stand for the distance on a straight line, this means D, which is the hypotenuse, D square from Pythagoras. Pythagoras said this hypotenuse, which is D square, is equals to the square of the opposite and the square of the opposite and the adjacent. That is square of x square minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square. From here, we'll say our distance is equal to the square root of x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. Using squaring both, adding square root to both sides, this is what we have. Now, we have a question here. This question says P is 2 and minus 3, Q is 3, comma minus 1. This shows that this is our first x, which is x1 and y1. The line, the first point is on this x1 and y1, and the second point is on x2, y2. Therefore, putting that into this equation, the distance D is equal to the square root of our x2, which is 3 minus our x1, 3 minus 2. Then we square it, plus our y2, which is minus 1, and our minus our y1 is minus 3. So that is minus 1, then minus minus 3, which gives us plus 3. Then we square it. Our distance is equal to the square root of 3 minus 3 gives us 1. This is 1 squared plus minus 3 plus 3 gives us 2. And that is 2 squared. 1 squared plus 2 squared gives us d equals to the square root of 5. So we'll be able to find the distance of that straight line. Now, in dealing with two coordinate geometry, we also have the polar coordinates. Polar coordinate deals with the distance of a straight line, but it deals with a two-dimensional coordinate system that talks about the distance and an angle from a reference point. Now, what this means, that is the angle of this reference point, which is written as theta, and then we have our r. From our vectors, we said r is equals to the square root of x square plus y squared, which is synonymously the same with the distance here we have. Finding the r, which is the distance of that angle, r is equals to our x squared. Let's say we have x to be minus 2 and we have y to be 2. This will be equal to the square root of minus 2 squared plus 2 squared. R is equals to square root of minus 2 gives us 4 plus 2 squared gives us 4. This is r is equals to the square root of 8. Now we've talked about the distance of that straight line on our polar coordinates. It uses x and y, but with reference to r and theta. Now, having the theta, to find theta, in our video on vectors, we talked about these angles and how these formulas were gotten. So you can also do yourself good to go back to check our videos on vectors. Now back to our topic. Having theta is equals to the tan inverse of our y over x. This is equals to the tan inverse of, we have our y to be 2 and we have our x to be minus 2. 2 divided by minus 2. This means the tan inverse, using our calculator, the tan inverse of minus 1 gives us minus 45. Therefore, this x and y coordinate we have here on polar coordinates will be written as our r, which is square root of 8, comma our theta, which is minus 45 degrees. Midpoint. Our formula for midpoint is x1 plus x2 over 2, comma y1 plus y2 over 2. Considering this very closely, we can see that this is talking about the average along the x-axis and the average along the y-axis, because we are dividing it exactly at the middle into two equal parts. That is what the midpoint is all about. Now let's say we have a question 2 comma minus 3, and then this is to be our p and our q. The other point is on 3 comma minus 1. Finding the midpoint of this, we name this x1, x2, and then x1, y1, and x2, y2. Putting this into this formula, we have x1 plus x2. Our x1 is 2 plus our x2 is 3 divided by 2, comma we have y1 plus y2. Our y1 is minus 1 plus our y2 is minus 1 plus our y1 is minus 3. Minus 3 over 2. This gives us 2 plus 3 over 2 gives us 5 over 2, comma minus 1 minus 3 gives us minus 4 over 2, which gives us minus 2. So this is dividing that line exactly at x 5 over 2 and at y minus 2. That is all about midpoint. Now, dealing with division of a line in a given ratio, the formula here says we are given the ratio m to n. This is equals to y minus y1 over y2 minus y equals to x minus x1 over x2 minus x. Now, considering this alone, trying to make y the subject of the formula here, we have y is equals to mx my2 minus plus ny1 over m plus n. Using subject of the formula, trying to bring out y. Now for the x, you have x to be equals to mx2 plus nx1 all over m plus n. So if I have to divide this line in the ratio 2 to 1, if we have 2 ratio 1, this means our m, this first 2 becomes m and the other 1 becomes our n. We only substitute that and our values for the x and y that we have. Now, dealing with equation of a straight line, the equation of a straight line is telling us about the equation with which that line was drawn. We could use the equation of a straight line to plot a straight line. Now, having equation of a straight line, the formula is y minus y1 is equals to mx minus x1. Now this can be gotten from our formula for our slope, like we did earlier in the video. Our formula for slope says m is equals to y minus y1 all over x minus x1. Now cross multiplying, we have this to be equals to this. Now y minus y1 equals to mx, m open bracket x minus x1. Using this question we have here, we are told to find the equation of this straight line having our gradient, which is m, to be minus 2 and xy to be minus 1 comma 3. Therefore, we'll say y minus our y1 becomes this y1, this is our x1, y minus y1, which is 3. Y minus 3 is equals to our m is minus 2 into x minus our x1 there, the tells us minus 1. Now y minus 3 is equals to minus 2 x plus 1. X plus 1. This gives us y is equals to, that is subtract, adding 3 to both sides. Minus 2 times x gives us minus 2x. Minus 2 times plus 1 gives us minus 2. Now carrying minus 3 to the other side becomes plus 3. Therefore y is equals to minus 2x minus 2 plus 3 gives us plus 1. We've been able to find the equation of the straight line here. The equation of a straight line is written in the form y equals to mx plus c when it has an intercept on x. Now thank you for watching today's tutorials. This we did a video on two-dimensional coordinate geometry. Thank you for liking, thank you for watching this video. Drop any comment or questions on this video and do ensure to send your messages or questions to our hotlines. We'll be dropping after this video. Thank you.